Hello and welcome to another very different end to the school year. Not the end that we had hoped for. I was really looking forward to the opportunity to gather together, perhaps in person, an outdoor mass like our older students would remember from before this thing we now call a pandemic, COVID-19 coronavirus. So I was thinking, we've been cooped up for too long. Rather than just stay here in the chapel, I want to take you on a bit of a pilgrimage, on a bit of a walk into the Chess Valley. So let's go.
I found peace in the river. I found peace by the quiet streams. And I found peace on the mountain. I found peace in the fields of green. And I found peace in the desert. I found peace in the raging waves. And I found peace in the valley. I found peace in what you said. Oh, when I can finally breathe again. I can finally.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So welcome to the beautiful Chess Valley, a place of great peace, tranquility, and beauty, right on the doorstep of our school. Now this is the place I've been bringing some Year 7s for their Year 7 retreat walks, and it really is a great place to bring them. Not only is it really close, but I think there's something really significant about a valley. Now, in a valley, quite often there will be some kind of river where all the rainwater that catches throughout the valley ends up. So here we have the Chess River at the bottom of the Chess Valley. Don't worry, Year 7s, this reflection will be a little bit different from what you experienced on the retreat walk. And those that haven't been on their retreat walk yet, this won't spoil anything that we're going to do. But for all of us, we've been on a bit of a journey and we've been in a bit of a valley. Now, along the Chess River at the moment are lots of banks that have been supported by sandbags. And now the sandbags are there to control the flow of the river. Now, usually a river will follow the path of least resistance. It will make its way around harder rocks, harder soils, going through the softer areas, and it will find its natural course. But at times when there is perhaps significant pressure from extra rainwater or through floods, the river can start to take a different course. And that can be quite destructive. Towns and cities can be flooded and destroyed with major river floods. But on the Chess Valley, they've simply added some sandbanks to help guide the river, to keep it on the course that it's flowed along for hundreds of years, and to prevent the destruction of the land around. Now, in these last 18 months and in this school year as well, we've all been under a significant extra pressure. There's been a lot of extra rain and our river has had a lot of extra pressure. And now there's been things along the way that have helped guide us and keep us from breaking from our natural course and being quite destructive. We've had our own sandbags. Now, some of those sandbags might have been positive experiences, people or friends that have helped keep us on course. Or some of those sandbags might have been more negative things. Perhaps there's been an illness or a death in the family. And that's what's caused us to think about life and where we're going and the direction that we're heading. And at the beginning of any liturgy, it's important for us to recognise that sometimes we don't always follow the good guidance that we're given by our loved ones, by our family, by friends and teachers, or the guidance that we're given by God. And so we think about the times when we haven't allowed ourselves to be guided on the best path. And that's not always our fault. Sometimes it's the circumstances that cause us to make bad choices. But regardless, we turn to our God who is merciful and we say, Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. And knowing that our God is good and he is full of mercy to those who ask, we make our way out of the depth of the valley and into a higher ground.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. The Lord your God himself will cross over and ahead of you. He will destroy these enemies before you, and you will take possession of their land. Do not be afraid or terrified because of them, for the Lord your God goes with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Then Moses summoned Joshua and said to him in the presence of all Israel, be strong and courageous, for you must go with this people into the land that the Lord promised to give them. The Lord himself goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Do not be afraid, do not be discouraged. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Having a sense of perspective is so important. The reading that we've just heard from the book of Deuteronomy is just before the people of Israel, who have been freed from Egypt, they've been wandering around the desert, and it's just before they cross over into the land that God has promised them. Now, before they cross over, they send in some scouts, they send in some spies to see who lives in the land and what obstacles they might have to overcome to take this great promised land. Now, most of the spies come back saying, the land is infested with giants, and if we go, we'll be destroyed. Yet other scouts come back with a more optimistic outlook and say how the land is flowing with milk and honey, with everything they need to thrive. Now, in this time of fear before crossing over, Moses reminds them that God goes ahead of them. He is with them and he goes ahead. Now, this sense of perspective that even in tough times, even in uncertainty, God is with us, this perspective is so important. And this is why I think a valley is such an important reflection to have. Especially when we can get up to a high place in the valley and look over where we've been. When we're in the midst of a difficult time, when we're at the bottom of the valley, when the banks of our river are overflowing with the pressure of life, it can be overwhelming. Our banks can burst. Our life can flood with despair. Everything can get damp and be miserable. And those moments seem to last a lifetime, and those moments seem like that's all there is to life at the moment. But if we're able to bring ourselves up out of the valley to a high place, we can get a fresh perspective. We can look down upon the valley and see that that moment of difficulty was just a moment. We can see where we were before the difficulty. We can remember a time before coronavirus, before COVID, before lockdowns, before being separated from our family and friends. And from the high place, we can also see where we'd like to be, where we'd like to go. We can plot a course, and we can make decisions that lead us closer to the person and the life that we want to have. You see, we're not always in control of the things that happen to us. Sometimes we have very little control of the circumstances in our life. But often we have more control than we think over our reaction, over how we respond. Now, we were able to try and garner your responses to a few questions about the last 18 months, about your own personal response to the coronavirus. What you liked about lockdown, what you found difficult, what you liked about school closures, what you thought about coming back. And the responses are mixed. For some people, being at home, learning at their own pace, not having to commute, that was a high place. It was a place of peace and success. Others struggled. Others found it isolating and difficult. Others became more aware of their negative attributes and difficulties. For some people, they could not wait to come back to school in September. Others found that the biggest challenge to overcome, and each day waking up was filled with anxiety and trepidation. And these responses, these feelings, these experiences were similar between staff and with pupils. Adults dreading each day of staring at a blank screen of icons, not knowing if there's anyone on the other end. Yet you still have to plan and prepare and give your all to the lesson, not knowing who's there to receive it. Pupils doing work, putting effort in, not knowing if there's anyone else in their class that's actually taking this seriously or doing their best. These times tested us. And we've already thought that we've been out of them. We already thought that we were coming back. Yet in January, we were thrown into another lockdown. And here we are at the end of the school year with partial closures, hearing about other schools closing, perhaps holiday plans being cancelled. It really sometimes feels that this will never end. For some of us, it still feels like we're at the bottom of the valley. So today, in this reflection, perhaps we can bring ourselves up to a high place. Perhaps we can take a moment to look at where we've been and actually see that there has been good and that there has been positive. That even if it's been tough, we have grown. We have changed. And perhaps we can train ourselves like Joshua the spy, who when he went into the promised land, he saw the giants, but he also saw the land that was flowing with milk and honey, the potential that there was. And perhaps from this high place at the end of the year, we can look back on the year and see the difficult times for what they were, challenges. We can see the sandbags that have tried to keep us on course. But we can also look ahead to a future full of optimism, full of hope, that we will overcome this.
We pray for all students of St. Joan of Arc School, particularly those for whom life is challenging and difficult, and for whom the pandemic has affected the most. We pray that we would all become more aware of God's constant, loving presence in our lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all the teachers and staff that have taught us, helped us, and worked for us throughout this year, and for those who are leaving St. Joan's this year. May we be always truly grateful for all their hard work. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all the pupils who are leaving St. Joan's this year. May the Holy Spirit give them peace of mind. We ask that God will guide them as they make plans for the future. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
And so as we make our way into a long-deserved summer holiday, let us ask God for his blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May he lift up his countenance to you and give you his peace. And may the Lord bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn